April 3rd. Running the first test of the quantum solenoid down this road. Speed test. Bus stop right down the road in record time. Although it wasn't recorded with visual, I didn't have anywhere to put the tablet. This was an incredible run of this device, which I've attached to the back of the bike. I'm calling the Quantum Solenoid. As you can see here, attached to the back of the bike. It's pretty good time. Sensations were a bit of a buzzing sensation. Running up my back, but my legs, but that's to be expected. It's messing around with ions, static charges. Let me show you the distance I've just covered. From the top of that hill to the bottom on a mountain bike. I'm gonna walk back up here for you. You're gonna see it for yourself, what I just did. Some unusual noises. Might have been the traffic on the road. There it is. That's the distance I just came. Just over a minute. Just about an eighth of a mile. And I got down there to that bus stop. There it is. Irrefutable proof, concrete proof, done with a video camera. which is proof that something is going on with this device. Originally invented by E.J. Gold as a beta blocker from Yo-Yo Dyne Incorporated, known as the Quantum Crystal Radios. People wear them as pendants in their necks. It became inspired by the technology. EJ said in his YouTube videos, a friend of his had leaked the schematics to him from NASA. NASA was interested in Nikola Tesla's crystal radio projects and his research in quantum science. I took off and began building my own variations of those very devices, using different components and parts. And like EJ, he used large components, small components. And so I started building my... You see that car at the top of the road? That's where we started out from, way up there. And went from there. If you can see that, right up there. Down to there. In just over a minute. On a mountain bike. Now you... I bring you evidence. I bring you stuff as best I can. It's a project I've been working on in secret. And on this 3rd of April here in Suffolk, beautiful, beautiful Suffolk day here on the 3rd of April, 2016. Beautiful, beautiful day. I'm bringing you skeptically, yes, it could just be a very good mountain bike. It is a hill. That's always a possibility. It's a 21 speed. It's not impossible to reach 45 miles an hour down a hill such as that one. On a mountain bike. Arguably, I should have worn a helmet. It's dangerous. It's absolutely a beautiful, beautiful landscape. Here in this Suffolk day. It's like something out of a fairy tale, like a fairy landscape. It's beautiful. Fairies are dancing and singing. And of course, this inventor, researcher, is out trying to break the quantum barrier. EJ's devices have been documented in, doing things that were unusual. My first experience with one was in 2013, and my son witnessed it. I lost 4 minutes, and my proof was my mobile phone that I had with me had in fact was 4 minutes behind. I wasn't trying to build something like this. I was trying to build... EJ's devices claim to help people become, you know, more psychic or connect to the dead. And that's what I was trying to do, was build variations of his project for that purpose. Still got a ways to go yet. What I discovered, they seem to be tampering with quantum fields quite a bit. And there was an unusual buzzing or cold burning sensation in my hands when dealing with the devices, indicating some kind of an ion discharge, very notably. And you had to touch metal. I had to touch the radiator or some pipe to discharge myself. It's like an effect we call St. Elmo's fire, like I was being charged up. And because these devices do use germanium diodes, at the core element of them. Radio diodes. And they've been wired in with a toroidal transformer. A donut transformer, if you know what those are, toroids. And with a lot of very high-powered capacitors. And a lot of copper. A whole lot of copper. I mean, that truck just took at least a few minutes to get up there. I think we're gonna walk this bike home. Disconnect the device from the bike. I didn't really notice anything else. There wasn't any excessive wind or slowing of time or anything really crazy like that. But I'm giving you, on this video, I'm recording up to the moment when the video took off, when it took off up there, to give you some idea the walk it takes to get back up this road. It's a considerable walk. You can't handle my device with your hands. It gives off like an ion shock or something. So it's encased in plastic. Covered in copper so as to create a capacitor effect. When we started out, right up here. Almost 9 or 10 minutes to get back up here. Shit. Like I said, I've been working on this in secret for the last 3 years. And, paranormal pictures, infrared pictures are one thing. But that's child's play next to what I've been doing here. That's kiddie stuff. All well and good. Entities in the forest. Oh, cool. Near a cell phone tower. Great. So I'll go make contact. Here we are. Where I started out. And that's 13 minutes. Alright. We'll cut the video. You get some idea. What called me to this stuff? What called me to EJ Cole? Well, call it a intuition. I don't know. Higher beings called me to do it. Yeah. But in any case, I've taken the work in directions that haven't been taken before. My devices are, a bit different than EJ's. I got a little bit more in them. The application of such a device could be even if this is time dilation on a microsecond, by microsecond, a microsecond, well then you'd have over minutes.